You know, Kevin, with Section 232, you've referenced a couple of times here. Why hasn't the administration, in my mind, at least, I don't think they've done a good enough job articulating to the American public that, you know, we, our aluminum production is at post-World War II levels, right? I mean, our steel production is so weak that it's not inconceivable we could have a major war in 10 years or 15 years. But you hear people go on television and the media all the time say it's no big deal. We can always get steel from our allies like Canada. Do we really want to be in the midst of a war relying on steel and aluminum imports from any other country, no matter who they are?
You know, you sound exactly like President Trump. When I discussed this with President Trump, you know, he'll remind everybody in the room that, you know, heck, we won World War II because we outproduced everybody. And a lot of the stuff that we were making, you know, was made out of steel and aluminum to some extent. And so to be prepared for war, he's the commander in chief. He has to think through, well, if we have a war, what are we going to be doing? And his view is we need to, in order to satisfy the demand for production of new products, we need to have a domestic industry that's much bigger and much healthier than we have. Now, that's a national security judgment, but, you know, guess what? The voters elected him to be commander-in-chief, and he's supposed to make those judgments.
There's been a lot of rumors for 2 or 3 weeks now of maybe a unilateral deal with Mexico. And in fact, most of the scuttlebutt has come out of Mexico from the highest officials over there. How close are we to a potential trade deal, and what would it look like? Because apparently it will be centered on how, what percentage of automobiles in this whole supply chain will be made on American soil.
Right, a deal with Mexico is very, very close. The team has been working overtime, late nights, going through what I would almost characterize as the final details. And, you know, we don't have a specific announcement to make right now, but you should stay tuned, because right now it's closer than it's been since I've been here. I've been here a little bit more than a year.
Where does that put Canada in the whole equation?
I think the hope is that the Mexican deal becomes a model for what Canada accepts with us as well. And so, you know, it should be good news for a deal with Canada as well if the Mexican deal moves forward.
In the last week, we're hearing in China that President Xi over there actually facing a lot more opposition than perhaps he thought he would. Of course, I mentioned earlier the flight of billions of dollars from that country over the last several years. But even in the media now, there's been some pushback, and he is starting to see some internal pressures. My question has always been, where does the Trump administration declare victory? What does victory look like that allows China's leader also to save a certain degree of face? You know, I keep saying that the art of the deal meets the art of war. Mm-hmm. What's the ultimate solution here?
Well, obviously that'll be up to the president, but I can say that economically, China needs to enter the community of nations. They need to start acting like the other developed nations. If I, you know, invented this new gizmo, then you'd be shocked if the German government stole it from me and then, you know, seeded a German startup company with my stolen idea. The Chinese government's doing that kind of thing all the time, and yet they're in the WTO. So China really needs to make up its mind. Do they want to be in the community of nations? They want to be a part of the WTO and just behave like everybody else, or don't they? And if they don't, then we, the community of nations, are going to have to think about, what are we going to do about that? Do we continue to let them stay in the WTO and so on? And it seems to me like cooler heads should prevail. And as you said, I think there are a lot of cooler heads in China right now that are saying, you know, geez, President Xi, maybe we should reconsider this path that we're on.
Well, yeah,
and,
listen,
and we certainly hope that they do.
They
could have a lot to contribute to a prosperous global economy if they would stop intellectual property theft and, you know, non-tariff barriers and all the sort of crazy stuff they do to advantage themselves.
And if reports are correct, pretty soon they may start to reorder those soybeans after they've gone through, you know, what they have in reserve, you know, and some of the other things. So, the notion that there's enough soybeans laying around in Brazil to feed 1.3 billion people, we know, is preposterous. So we know that the administration has leverage. But again, I'm always concerned about what victory looks like that can be shared by everyone. But you mentioned the WTO. That thing's got to be blown up. I mean, that's you go all the way back to the General Agreement on Tariffs and Trade back to post-World War II. You got many more partners. You've got technology. You know, we need to have we need to revamp all of these things. So just saying, hey, follow the rules. They are following the rules right now, the WTO, Kevin. We know that, and they're abusing them. They call themselves an emerging country. They say we're in the same level as Togo, right? So, you know, don't we need to blow up the WTO manifesto, if you will, and put something in place that protects all nations?
Well, I think that you're right that we need to reform it. It's not working the way it is. And you know, there's one disagreement I have, though, is it's not really like China's following the rules. The rules are there. The problem is it takes them 5 or 6 years of deliberation to figure out that China's cheating. And by then, the story's over. And so, you know, they've been abusing the rules, I think, is the better way to describe what they've been doing. And that's why there needs to be a WTO reform.
I think you're absolutely correct. Chairman Kevin Hassett, thank you very
Thanks,
much.
Guys.
Appreciate your
Thanks
time this morning.
Me.